Well, good afternoon, adventurers, and I am out here in Slab City, kind of looking around, and I'm out here at Dot's place, and I know that they're getting ready for another blazing hot summertime. So I just want to say hello, Dot.
Hi. Well, I have high expectations for a cooler summer, so we'll hope. We'll hope that this keeps up with
yeah,
this.
Yeah, let's hope that it's cooler weather. Summer this year.
It's been a cooler spring, so right. Maybe a cooler summer.
And she's nice. She's getting ready for summertime, and she's going to show us some of the things that she's doing.
So we're creating shade as much as possible anywhere we can.
Nice.
And working on getting this area set up, the Mermaid Cove, which we did a lot of construction on it the past couple of weeks or so to try to get it ready for summer so that I can be hidden inside here. So we moved the entrance to back here
because very nice.
I was fighting that, so you can even see the sun's coming in from this side, and so it does that all the way till it gets way over here. So that's the biggest, this side right here gets the most sun in the later afternoon. That's annoying. So I made sure I covered over my door and brought the door in over here, so that'll come up and over, which will make this all have no sun coming in, and the door will just come in.
This is the new entrance.
New backside entrance. And so we're getting there. I kind of made a pergola style ceiling roof with some picket fences that I double sided.
Now there's something scientific about this, right? It helps keep things cool.
So the layering effect of the shade cloth, it's like the more layers that you add, the cooler the temperatures get as it moves through the layers. I will probably do another layer, especially up and over through here. That's why I really like the picket fence idea, because I can do layer by layer by layer coming down and really drop the temperature in here. And then we'll have the pool completely shaded and with the little fountain and some sprinklers and things going on with some fans in here. It should be quite nice.
I'm thinking a summertime video pool party at Dot's.
All right. Yeah, bring a floaty.
Heck yeah.
Although I do have a nice size air mattress, and I've always wanted to do that. Put an air mattress like
and float on the air mattress inside the
lake or whatever. Yeah.
Yeah, one of the big that are almost like a lounge chair.
Exactly. Like just lay on it. And like so with this thing, if it's shooting water and just, I think we'll see how it works out.
Yeah, really nice.
So all the lights and stuff will have to come out because the bees will want to hang out in there. It's really dirty. We're about to just unplug it and let that go and clean it real good and fill her up.
Yeah.
Maybe in the next couple weeks.
Little things that float around and suck all the algae out.
That's the only kind of fish I would think of putting in there. But yeah, I think this year I'm just going to get another sprinkler pump kind of thing to go in the middle. More like a sump pump concept with the that sprays a fountain. Hopefully it'll spray a fountain. Even if it just gurgles, that's fine. And I'll only have that in there when I'm not swimming in it. But it'll add some ambiance. The noise.
Now,
the noise
of the water. Do people around here in the slabs know that you have a pool and they're all over here in the summertime?
So everyone knows I have a pool, and I just tell everybody they need to get their own pool. I mean, they're not that expensive, especially if you buy them off season. And I always tell everybody that it gets to the end of the season, and I'm always reminding people, go get your pool. If you didn't get one, go get it, because they'll be 50% off. I'm sure of it. No one ever does. But I mean, a lot of people use the canal, or they come up with their unconventional pools, like out of water tanks or horse troughs. You know, I would love a porcelain club foot tub. That would be really nice.
Oh,
if,
be cool.
If anyone has one of those.
Porcelain club foot tub. Send me a message. I'll send it over to Dot.
That would be kind of nice. Have that just in here.
Nice.
Yeah.
Have you added any more to your terror room over there?
It's always getting added to. I'm not sure if there's been anything specifically added since you were here
that
last.
Was the Barbie.
The Barbie horror house hasn't changed too much.
Nice.
No, been really concentrating on getting this together. That's been kind of the motivation. And have a room I really want to hang out in for the summer. Last year I was convinced I was going to work on stuff all summer.
Beautiful.
No, you're not going to work on anything here. The time for working will be when I can be in there. And that trailer has the cool top on top of it, which, hot damn, that stuff works.
So you're prepping something in there.
It's just a nice open space in there.
Oh,
yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, I don't think it's unlocked. It is unlocked. Well, I don't know if I want you.
Well, we'll have to come back and follow up with Dot.
Yeah.
It's always a joy to come out and talk to you, Dot,
same
out here
to
in
you.
Slab City.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much, Dot, for the little update.
Yeah.
We always appreciate you. And so, like I always say, embrace that positivity, get rid of that negative stuff in your life, the negative people, and just do good stuff, make good memories, be positive. Life is too short for anything but joy. And from the House of Dots in Slab City, this is Elvis Boy, and we'll see you next time, Dot. Thank you so much.
See you guys later. Bye.